Kima, on one hand, that of India, the most of valueless, but on the other hand, has not taken. Has not taken seriously. But you know, this is very inconvenient. If the person is heavy, person may have two stiffness of the joint, fixing, supporting the thigh by one hand to the mobilization of that. So, we'll do it in prone leg. I'll show it up to a prone leg. That's the problem. You position out of the sector, you can give. So what Maitland has said, place your thumb on the anterior aspect of the proximal tibia close to the joint line, then push it. But you know, again, applying pressure by the thumb to a stable joint like knee is not going to be practically speaking, it is not going to be. So what you usually do, you can place your first to a space, or maybe the heel of the hand. First to a space, and push it. Your forearm should be perpendicular to the tibia, or maybe the heel of the hand. Forearm should be perpendicular.
If the other one is,
if you flex foot like, feet on, tibia, grab the upper tibia, the both hands. As I pull it forward, leaving back, I try to translate the upper of the tibia posterior anteriorly. And as I push it, I apply anterior to posterior. So simultaneously, I can give anterior to posterior and posterior. Or whichever is linked on. You can pull it. Suppose you have anterior line here, just pull it. You want to give posterior line, push it. Then, to finally hip reflex, place one hand on the medial lateral aspect of the femur, other hand on the medial aspect. So I push femur lateral to medial and pull the tibia medial to lateral. This is lateral glide of the tibia over the femur. Similarly, if I push my, press my hand on the medial aspect of the femur and other hand on the lateral aspect and apply equal and opposite reactive force, so this is lateral to medial glide of the tibia over the. Right, if you don't use body weight, you want to use your muscle force. Your forearms are flexed one and out. But that medial aspect of the lateral aspect, both the forearms are parallel, so you can just apply the movement.
Thank you.
That is what Maitland said. Anterior glide of the tibia. But here again the problem is
thumb.
Applying pressure by thumb.
Stability.
One may not able to tolerate. Or you may not able to apply the required amount of force. Number two, area of contact is less by the thumb. So pressure will be more, which patient may not tolerate. Number three, there are various neurovascular structure present in the knee. So when you apply pressure over a small area, do not know if it damages or compresses either of the neuromuscles. So considering that, you know, what do you do? You place the heel of the hand, blocks the tibia, forearm is perpendicular to the tibia, with the other hand and support the tibia, and press. Use the body weight, the strength elbow, to glide the tibia upwards to the knee. I want to give hindrance under glide this one 90 degree. So my forearm should be horizontal. If I support, what should matter? I want to give under to post of glide hindrance deflection. So support the tibia for the hindrance. My heel of the hand is just close to the tibia articulate surface. For us, perpendicular to the tibia and pull the tibia and to the posterior. For entrance, inflection. Chalo, ho gaya. Any